Concept is adders. An adder is a digital circuit that performs addition of numbers. In many computers and other kind of processors, adders are used in the arithmetic logic unit. The main concept of adders is it is used to provide an addition operation between two inputs. For example, if you take A equal to 2 and B equal to 3, 2 plus 3 equal to 5. This is the operation performed by the adders. So, the types of adders, classifications of adders are off adder, full adder, ripple carry adder, carry look ahead adder, carry save adders. Off adder is a combinational circuit that adds two numbers and produces a sum bit and carry bit as the outputs. So here off adder it will be hanging two inputs and two outputs. The outputs are represented as sum and carry. Second point, if A and B are the input bits, the sum bit S is the XOR gate of A and B, and carry bit C will be AND gate of A and B. Here sum bit will be represented as XOR gate and carry bit will be represented as AND gate of A and B inputs. So this is a truth table and logic diagram of the off adder. So this is a logic diagram of off adder and the truth table of the off adder. Here you will be having two inputs. The possible inputs will be 2 power of 2, that is equal to 4. So the possible outputs will be 4 for the off adder. And in off adder will be hanging drawback that it can be applied only for two inputs. It cannot be applied for more than two inputs. So that's why we are going for the next concept, that is in full adder. Full adder which adds three inputs. They are A, B and C in. It has two outputs. They are sum and carry. Full adder are made from XOR and OR gates in the hardware. With the help of the following gates, you can design the full adder. And full adder also can be designed with the help of two off adders and one OR gate. So here, this is the logic diagram of the full adder and this is the truth table of the full adder. Here, as we said that, so it is a combination of two off adders and one OR gate. So this is the first off adder and this is the second off adder. Off adder is nothing but a combination of one XOR gate and one AND gate. So this is one off adder and this is another off adder. So and this is OR gate. So a full adder can be designed with the help of two off adders and one OR gate. And here we are having three inputs. So the possible inputs will be 2 power of 3, that is equal to 8, therefore from 0 to 7. So next concept is that is a ripple carry adder. A ripple carry adder is constructed by cascading full adder blocks in series. So this is the logic diagram to represent the ripple carry adder. As we have said in the first point, so it is provided a connection in the form of series of full adders. And second point, each full adder input a Cin, which is the Cout of the previous adder. Here they are telling, so the C naught will be act as input for full adder B and the same C naught will be taken as an output of the full adder A. For example, if you go for here, C1 will be taken as an input for the full adder C and the same C1 will be represented as the output of the full adder B. So this is a representation of the a logic diagram of ripple carry adder. So why ripple carry adders is called, so why we are calling it as a ripple carry adder? In ripple carry adder, the carry out produced by each full adder will be as carry in for its adjacent most significant full adder. Here the carry out produced by the full adder A will be taken as a carry in of the next adjacent of full adder. So for full adder A, this is an adjacent full adder B. So for this full adder B, the C naught will be taken as an input carry and for the same C naught will be represented as an output for an full adder A. So each carry bit ripples or waves into the nestade. So here C0 and C1, C2, so they will be act as an rippling of the carry to the nest full adder. So that's why it is called to be ripple carry adder. So disadvantages of the ripple carry adder. So ripple carry adder does not allow to use the full adders simultaneously. So here it cannot be used all the full adders simultaneously. So why? So each full adder has to necessarily wait until the carry bit becomes available from it adjacent full adder. So here, so if you want to work the full adder B, it need to wait until full adder A produces the C0, and full adder C should be wait until C1 is produced by the full adder B. So that's why it cannot work simultaneously, and this increases the propagation time, means so it leaves more amount of time. So due to this reason, ripple carry adder becomes extremely slow. So why we are telling here, all the full adders cannot be worked simultaneously due to this, so it becomes very slow. This concept, carry look ahead adder. So carry look ahead adder is an improved version of ripple carry adder. It generates the carry in of each full adder simultaneously without causing any delay. Here in the name itself we are having carry look ahead adder, means so ahead means before only. So before only, a carrier will be produced for a particular full adder. So that's why they have been named this one as a carry look ahead adder. And this is a logic diagram for the carry look ahead adder, and these are called to be an combinational circuits which are going to be used for create the carrier for each full adder. So for that purpose we need to go for this equation that is said to be as a carrier generator and carrier propagator. With the help of the carrier generator and carrier propagator, so we can be produce the carrier with the help of this combinational circuits for all the last three full adders. So initial full adder, it will be not having any combinational circuit. For this one, you will be giving the carrier in, and rest of the full adders, the carrier will be produced with the help of the combinational circuits, and this combinational circuits will be using this carrier generator and carrier propagator, where carrier generator is nothing but GI is equal to AI into BI, and carrier propagator is nothing but PI equal to AI XOR into BI. So with the help of this carrier generator and carrier propagator in the combination circuits, we can create the carrier for each full adders. So advantages, the advantages of the carrier look ahead adder are, it generates the carrier in for each full adder simultaneously. It reduces the propagation delay. So with the help of this combinational circuit, we can be created the carrier in for each full adder, and it can be worked simultaneously. And disadvantages, the disadvantages of the carrier look ahead adder are, it involves the complex hardware. So the hardware will be in the form of complicated. It is costlier since it involves the complex hardware. So due to presence of complex hardware, so the cost will be increased. And third point, it gets more complicated as number of bits is increased. So here for example, if you go, so this is a 4-bit carry look ahead adder. If you go for more amount of bit, then automatically it becomes more complicated. The next concept is carrier save adder. So here we are representing the block diagram representation of the carrier save adder. So here, so this represents the full adder block, and the full error block will be converted for the carry save adder. Here the 3 bits will be applied simultaneously in the form of parallel. So procedure of CSA, that is nothing but carry save adder. In carry save adder, 3 bits are added parallelly at a time, as we have seen in the previous slide. In this scheme, carry is not propagated through the stages. Here is carry is stored in present state and updated as an addend value in the next stage. So here the carry will be stored in present stage and it will be updated as an addend value for the next stages. Hence the delay due to this carry is reduced. So carrier delay will be reduced in the carry save adder. So this is the circuit diagram of the carrier save adder. So here it is a 4 bit carrier save adder. So where A, B, C, and here these are the following inputs we have been applied it. So this one A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2, B3, and here it is in C0, C1, C2, C3. So these are the following inputs are applied to the upper portion of the full adder. So these are an upper portion of the full adder. So here we will be applying A0, B0, C0. For this one and for second one A1, B1, C1, and for third one A2, B2, C2, and the fourth one A3, B3, C3. These are the inputs we have been applied for the following full adders, and for this full adders you will be getting sum and carry, and the sum and carry are given to the lower portion of the full adder. So here in the here the C out represents the carrier generator. So here the at this portion the carrier will be a generator. See, at last you will be getting sum is equal to 100101 here. So here S5, S4, S3, S2, S1 and S0. So these are going to be represents the following inputs.